Okay, just a little progress report on this. So I've been cleaning the inside with the acetic acid, and today what I wanted to do was take out this heater. So I've been kind of chiseling away. They had some kind of like glue or something like that that would be here for sealing, and now I just want to, looks like that's kind of a temperature rheostat that turns it on and off for the heat, where you can set it to the temperature you want. So anyways, I'm gonna try and take all this off, and now I'm not 100% sure what I'm gonna be doing with this, but at least I don't want any contamination inside this tank when I'm cleaning it, so, or when I'm cooking with it. So I'm basically wanting to remove all the non-copper, non-brass parts, and because that could hinder the taste or anything like that, it could hinder that. So I'm gonna just kind of take out this stuff, save those screws so they don't get into a tire, and see what's in there, because I imagine the heater element probably goes in pretty deep, but how deep I'm not 100% sure. So let's put that there for now. And yeah, it looks like that is like fixed right in there. So, well, let's see here. I guess we'll have to undo that ground there. I'll have to undo those nuts and pull this up and out. Probably just gonna cut that. Okay, got that unbolted. Now should okay. Well, I wonder if I can use that for something. Seems like be like a circuit interrupter kind of thing. Rheostat would be handy for something, but so I think I'm gonna make a cut right here, and I'm gonna make a cut right here, and then see if I can move this. Now, I chiseled all that stuff out of that crack there, but if I go to press and go to chisel this, then it ends up pushing the thing down. And I've already put a little tiny pinhole ink right there, so I'm gonna want to be really careful. I think I'm just gonna cut, and then I'm gonna see if I could chisel it. A huge monkey wrench would be ideal, but I don't think I have anything that big. But if I have to, I guess I could drill a hole, and then maybe I can just stick something in here and see if I can turn it. I don't know. I don't know if that would work. It's probably just gonna end up snapping the things off. But I don't know. Yeah, just kind of have to massage it. Yeah, it feels very, very solid here. Probably just gonna have to work it back and forth and see what else I can come up with to get that to come up and out. I hope I don't have to cut it or anything like that. See how effective. Oh, basically turned it all So this is all the acetic acid that's reacted with the calcium and the copper. So every day I just kind of slosh this around inside, and then I did mix some hot water with this. So we pretty much got it all out there. So it is doing its thing. Good thing this stuff isn't flammable. Alright, now what we're gonna do. So the reason I need a hole for the inside of this is so I can put the mash inside of here. This is gonna be the highest point, so the vapor is gonna come out this. But I'm gonna make a slice like here and here and see if I can turn this out. So, safety third with these brand new glasses, never been used. And this is the incorrect blade, but here goes nothing. see if I can get this out now with my chisel. See if this will. Well, that's not exactly working. It's not the best chisel, but we do have more to choose from. Let's try this one, which already has a messed up end on it. But we can go from this way as well. This is tricky. Oh, something went flying. Let's try it the other way. Okay, it's not exactly gonna want to come out when we're denting the roof here. Well, we might have to just cut this out. Seems like it's really stuck on there. I'm not sure what to do. Maybe try prying it back up again. Yep, might have to use the death wheel here and see if we can cut it open a little bit more. Wicked vibration there. Yeah, it seems like it's hanging on for dear life. Not really. Let's see here. Get the idea of this, right? Okay, I got all this stuff around. I've just been able to move it. Okay, let's see what we can do here. Ah, good. Oh, wow. So it is threaded, but of course this is UK thread, so it's all weird. But half of it is gone. Half of the threads is broken off there inside. So now I have a spot to put stuff in, and I can take I can pressure wash off in the inside. And look at all that. Alright, well, I think that'll do it for this episode. I think I gotta take it to the shop now and power wash the inside, and we'll be one step closer.